from Auburn, Alabama. A beautiful Sunday afternoon. It is the first New Year SEC basketball game for Auburn and Georgia on the Plains. We welcome you to Auburn Arena on this Sunday afternoon. Georgia and Auburn, two teams looking for their first win in Southeastern Conference play. Folks making their way inside Auburn Arena, getting set for SEC women's basketball. Glad to have you along with Renee Montgomery. I'm Richard Cross. Renee, two teams trying to get that first win in league play.
Yeah, and you know, two teams trying to get that win. One team is without their leading scorer and rebounder in a unique Thompson. So it's going to be a tough fight for Auburn, but I look forward to it.
Players to watch in this ballgame. Let's start with Georgia. Jenna Stady has been a machine for the Lady Dogs. She is double-double after double-double.
She is, and good luck trying to get anything in the paint on Jenna. As you say, she doesn't even have to leave the floor much to block these shots. She can also get down and finish around the rim, so I look for her to have a big game tonight.
You mentioned a second ago, the Auburn Tigers are without Unique Thompson, and she leads them in everything.
She really does. She's a double-double machine. She actually set the school record for double-doubles. She's good at gobbling anything that comes around her way as far as rebounds are concerned. And then she has a good touch around the basket. She uses her dribble. As you see here, she gets to the other side of the rim to finish. So that's a big blow for Auburn, and a lot of other people are going to have to step up.
Second consecutive game, Unique Thompson has been out. She is out because of medical reasons, though she is not injured. And that means Romy Levy and Aisha Kula Bailey have got to come on and try and grow and take advantage of this opportunity.
They definitely do, but you know, both players played well last game, combining for 20 points and 16 rebounds. They're going to have to do that and then some to combat with Georgia missing one of their star players.
I knew I was going to mess up her name the very first time. I did it. Aisha Kula Bailey, the freshman from Mali in Africa. Try not to let it happen again. So two teams looking for a win in SEC play. Georgia is coached by Joni Taylor. She is in her sixth season. Was a longtime assistant coach. Couple of trips to the NCAA tournament in 2016 and in 2018. For Auburn, it's Terry Williams-Flannoy. She is in her ninth season on the Plains. 140 wins, 123 losses, four wins, seven losses against the University of Georgia, a place that she knows well. She was a former assistant, was on Andy Lander's staff. So it's time for basketball. Auburn at home in white, Georgia the road team in red. Dee Kantner, Angelica Suffren, and Carla Fountain.
When I tell you Dee Kantner, she was one of my refs, and she's now still out here. I love to see it. They have a seasoned ref. And also, shouts to Joni Taylor. Her husband, Darius Taylor, is the assistant coach for the Atlanta Dream, who was my coach during this last couple seasons. So I have a lot of ties out there right now.
It's the first time you would like officials, though, right?
You know, I never really had much problem with officials. I kind of keep to my own.
Auburn trying to establish inside early. Richard Cross, Renee Montgomery with you on the Plains. Glad to have you along. Georgia's starting five, Gabby Connolly, Maya Caldwell, Jenna Stady, who we talked about, averaging 15 and 8, along with Jordan Isaacs and Q Morrison, starters for the Lady Dogs. Stady overshot it, but an offensive rebound and a putback, and Georgia scores first.
Yeah, that's exactly what Georgia can do with their size. They're going to constantly be getting rebounds and putbacks all night. Got to box them out on the first one.
Kia Patton, Romy Levy, Jayla Jordan, Elena Rice, and Honesty Scott Grayson, the starters for the Auburn Tigers.
And we just talked about Georgia having the size. Auburn right there hustled to the loose ball and was the first to the ball. That's what they have to do, use their speed against that size.
Elena Rice works down the left side of the lane. Shot clock inside five. Got to let it fly. And a shot clock violation on Auburn. It's Georgia basketball going the other way.
Now, right there, if you're Auburn, there needs to be four other players letting her know that the shot clock is going down. It didn't seem like she was aware.
Inside to Stady. She touches it on each of the first two offensive possessions, and I think you'll see a lot of that today.
You will, but that's a great defense by Jordan, keeping her hands straight up and just making it a difficult shot.
Into the lane, Jayla Jordan.
And the same thing back by Jenna, so these two are clearly going to battle all night long. Oh.
Layup won't go in transition for Connolly. Pretty good feed to her, just couldn't finish, and now Auburn's got it.
again. You see right here, look, just getting your hands that length. I'm telling you, that length of Jenna, it's going to be tough all night for Jordan, but it's going to be the same on the other end because Jordan did the same thing to her. She didn't block the shot, but she altered it.
With Stady, you mentioned it in the open, Renee. Really doesn't have to leave her feet along because of that length and positioning. When you think about shot blockers, you think about, you know, getting way up in the air and swatting it away.
Yeah, absolutely. And for her, that's good because you always tell the defensive player, don't leave your feet and get out of position. Well, she doesn't. And now you can see Auburn is in a zone right now, changing up the look. Got a steal.
And a turnover trying to feed it into the high post. Levy coming the other way, and now Rice out front. Wayne Rice, the point guard, sophomore from Rockledge, Florida.
Oh.
Trying to feed it into the lane on a cutter to Patton, and a turnover by Auburn.
Yeah, that's a tough pass right there. The defender ran it all the way. And that's exactly what you have to do against a zone. Get it to the high post and then look straight for the high-low look. You have a big tower down there in Jenna. Perfect execution.
Isaacs with the assist. Jenna Stady with the bucket. And Georgia back in front by a deuce. For Auburn, it's about finding somebody that can score, can kind of get things going.
Yeah, and just take a look at this high-low. So we know it's a zone. What do? You're going to set the screen. You slip it, and Jenna Stady is right there, posted up on the block, getting the inside position, easy pass and finish. You can hear a lot of chatter. The thing about a quiet gym is you can hear everything the coaches have to say. And the coaches were telling them to get out, clear out that side. They wanted to drive. They ended up getting the play anyway, but they wanted the side to be cleared a little bit sooner.
Patton on the drive draws the foul from Jenna Stady. So what's the balance between going at a player like Stady, because you'd love to get her in foul trouble, but knowing that she's such a great shot blocker?
You do. You have to go at her, but the thing about it is you have to go into a player like Stady's body. You can't just let her length and her arms guard you. You have to take your body into her body and then finish with contact, because you can't assume the refs are going to call it, even though they did there for Chapman.
Couple of free throw opportunities, makes one of two. It's a one-point game.
And again, there's that high post that I keep talking about. That's where you have to get the ball every time in the zone.
Good bucket there for Q Morrison. She averages 10 points per game. Morrison coming off an 11-point performance against Mississippi State.
And Morris can get that shot all night in the zone. They're setting a screen on the top defender. If she comes off of that looking to score, she can get that all night.
Scott Great Grayson pass. Too strong with the jumper.
Good
in
pass.
Transition. Bucket for Q Morris and back-to-back buckets for her.
And that's what you do. You get the ball out and you run. And here, what I love about this is keeping your head up while you're dribbling up the court. Of course, you know it's a fast break. As you saw, you had players in front of you, you had horses in front of you, but just getting it ahead, the ball always moves faster than the dribble.
So Scott Grayson goes to the bench for Auburn. And Andy Hughes checks in for the first time today.
And you see Georgia with that full court press, just adding a little bit of pressure to make the offense not run so smoothly. No problem for Auburn, though.
Floater in the lane there for Kia Patton.
And Kia Patton's played well early. She's taken it to the basket. She had a floater, and then as you see again, another bucket by Jenna. That's going to be tough. She has such size that you can't let her get so close to the rim.
Got the good seal and was able to get it up off the window. Georgia by five. Aisha Koulibaly, who did not start today, the freshman, averaging 5 points and four rebounds a game.
Okay, Aisha. She didn't start, but she finished that one. Oh, wait, did they call a foul?
She was looking around as if to say, what are we doing? Kantner is talking now with Terry Williams-Flannoy.
Oh, man, that's tough. That's tough. Maybe I missed something, but I kind of like when players get excited after they take it. That was a great defensive play. Somebody was out of position behind her. She was guarding Jenna on the strong side block. They threw it to the weak side block. She recovered and blocked it anyway. I love the effort. It's tough to get a technical off of that, but I love the effort there.
We'll take another look when we come back. Georgia with a three-point lead. Coach Williams-Flannoy not entirely pleased with DeCantner right now. We'll be back.
Looking forward to this season?
Yep. Been working on my anticipation. Got to stay one step ahead.
Anticipation is key. So are you...
Enjoying life in the house? Always. Yeah, my family's doing good. Thanks for asking. You should probably get that. It's your mom.
Hello?
Hi.
Hey, Mrs. Tebow. Chicken and waffle sounds great. Nice talking to you too, Mrs. T.
Yes.
Yes.
But
don't even think about asking me that.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on all the food that makes your boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grub, what you love.
Georgia with a three-point lead over Auburn. Couple of free throws coming up when we come out of this timeout for a technical foul that was called just a moment ago on Aisha Koulibaly.
This one's tough for me. The great hustle play. I love when players show passion, emotion. I don't think there's enough there. Koulibaly, actually, she got hit in the face after she blocked it. That's just excitement for making a good play. I understand that you don't want the taunting of players back and forth, but for me, as a teammate, that would get me excited. I would probably be doing the same to Aisha. So that's a tough play after a player comes in and makes two great plays, one on offense and then one on defense.
Koulibaly coming off that 12-point performance against LSU. Our women's basketball doubleheader for next Thursday. Hopeful that Tennessee will be back on the court for this one after a positive COVID-19 test that has paused all activities. They're slated to square off against number 10 Arkansas in Knoxville. That's at 6:30 Eastern, followed by a top 15 matchup at Reed Arena in College Station. Number 13 Kentucky and number 9 Texas. Both games on the SEC Network and streaming, as always, on the ESPN app. The first time out of the game has Georgia leading it by 3 over Auburn, up 10-7. We've got a technical foul that was called on Aisha Koulibaly. Koulibaly, from the continent of Africa, played in Mali. She was on the U16 national team at the 2017 Africa Championship. And really seems to be coming into her own. And you know, we talked about it at the outset, Renee. You've got to have players that step up. In the absence of Unique Thompson, who is averaging almost 19 points and a little better than 15 rebounds per game. She's missing her second consecutive game for Auburn because of medical reasons.
Yeah, and you know, Aisha is a player that can step up. As you see, as soon as she checked in, she didn't start, but she came into the game aggressive, got a bucket on offense, and then made a spectacular play on defense. Again, the play, it wasn't her man that she came over on that weak side and made the block, so I hope that that technical doesn't deter her from her aggressiveness and that she keeps, because sometimes that can break your momentum. If you get a technical and you come into the game juiced up and you're excited, then you get a technical, it can almost simmer you down. So I hope that doesn't stop her and she continues to play with that energy.
Connolly makes one of the two technical free throws. That was only her second miss from the free throw line this season. It was 15 of 16 coming in. Connolly from the wing knocks out the triple.
Big shot by Connolly, and that's what you have to do against a zone. They're trying to keep the ball out of the paint. If you make some shots from outside, they're gonna have to get out of that zone.
Drive, a little out of control there. An offensive foul on Elena Rice.
Great defense.
We'll skip pass, set up Gabby Connolly.
And again, that's a shot that Connolly can get all night long. When a team is sitting in a zone, the skip pass is going to set up the shooters. Way to have your feet set and ready to shoot.
That was her 150th career three-pointer at Georgia. Connolly climbing into the top 10. She now sits at number 9 all by herself.
Okay.
Not sure she's going to catch Corey Chambers, though. 282 career threes.
Yeah, I don't know. But as you see here, Auburn extended their defense past three-quarter court. Another one. She might have heard you.
She said, don't sell me short. We got a lot of games to play.
She got another one. But again, that's a shot that she can get all night in that zone.
10-point lead for the Lady Dogs, up 17-7 on Auburn on the road. Georgia started the season 8-0.
Yeah.
Dropped their SEC opener. There's an offensive foul.
Second one in a row.
Auburn number 14, Jayla Jordan. That's her first.
Jayla Jordan called for an illegal screen. This was Connolly again.
And again, Connolly, this great job by Connolly making her second three in a row. But if you're Auburn, if a player just made a three, you got to inch a little bit closer to them the next time. Don't just let her line it up and shoot it all night.
Cross court pass, another open three from the wing. This one too strong from Q Morrison.
But if you're Morrison, that's a shot that the defense is going to give you.
Auburn trying to answer with a deep ball. This one won't go for Romy Levy. Levy shooting 32% from behind the arc this year.
Yeah, you know, it's going to be tough. It's going to be tough for Auburn to produce points because missing a player like Unique Thompson, it's not just her 19 points and her 15 boards that you miss. It's the attention that the defense pays to her while she's on the court that gets other people open shots. That's what they're really going to miss.
New players in for Georgia, Chloe Chapman, Sarah Ashley Baker, and Michaela Coombs all check in for the first time today.
And now Georgia, you can see, is in a zone of their own on defense.
Barker runs down the rebound. They'll push it up the floor. Sarah Ashley Barker, named SEC Freshman of the Week a couple of weeks back for her performances.
Her great performances.
Against East Carolina and Oklahoma.
Great ball movement. That's exactly how you bust the zone open. You penetrate the zone with a pass, and then you look for the cutters or the opposite weak side for a three. I mean, you have to be excited if you're Joni Taylor about how your team is playing against this defense.
Javen Nicholson with the bucket there. One thing that's evident early with Georgia this year, and probably important in a season like this, she's playing a ton of players, regularly 11 players getting into the game.
Yeah, and as a player, you know that, okay, the subs are coming in and out quickly, so you can give it your all. You don't have to pace yourself. And then if you're Taylor, you're excited because with a lot of things going on, different players having to sit out for COVID, different things, different injuries, your team is ready with a lot of players getting to play. And now this is the third offensive foul this game against Auburn, so the refs are paying close attention to it. It was a push-off, so it was the correct call. Auburn's going to have to pay more attention to pushing off on their dribble.
So that was Morgan Robinson-Waku picking up her first foul. 2:08 left in the first quarter. Georgia with a 12-point lead. Lady Dogs have made 6 of their last 7 from the field.
And that's exactly what you don't want to see if you're a team that's in a zone defense. You hope that they're missing from the outside, but Georgia, they're knocking it in.
You look at what Georgia is doing different this year offensively. They average 63 a game, up to almost 79 points per game this year. Field goal percentage is up. Three-point shooting is up. They seem to be a more confident offense.
Everything's up, and you know what? It's down, though. They're holding their opponents to 56 points per game, so they're averaging 79 and holding their opponents to 56. So that's exactly what you want to see if you're a team. Offense up, defense down.
Yeah, you're going to win a lot of games when you get a 22-point margin of victory.
Yeah, they've won a lot of games already. 8 games to be exact, started out to that hot start, 8-0.
Georgia dropped its SEC opener 69-62 at Stegman to Mississippi State.
And that's what you have to do if you're Auburn. You can't, a lot of times on the Auburn offense, the ball is just doing windshield wipers. It's going all across the outside. You have to drive the ball to the paint, take it at him. I know there's a size difference and it looks intimidating, but again, you have to get into their body. You have to make the ball move. You can't just stand outside and pass around.
Four Free throws here for Annie Hughes. She is 4 of 7 from the line on the season. Makes the first. Annie Hughes, a sophomore from Dutton, Alabama.
And if you're Annie Hughes, you use these free throws to kind of get yourself going, see the ball go through the rim so that you're ready. Oh, she missed that one, but so that you're ready when your time comes to shoot.
One out of two at the line there. Near turnover by Georgia, able to keep the possession alive.
Good
Chloe
pass.
Chapman with the quick hands and then a bucket. Good look there from Michaela Coombs.
And the thing about it is Georgia is so willing to share the ball. It's tough to guard when the ball is hopping around everywhere. Auburn's running around. They're trying to close out. They're trying to play good defense, but the ball is moving so quickly for Georgia. That's what you do.
Ayesha Coulibaly with the bucket. She's got a free throw coming up as well.
And here, look at this. Georgia, you can see Coulibaly comes out to try to pick up the man driving. She dumps it down to that weak side block has been open all night long. So Auburn's going to have to pay closer attention to that. But great job by Georgia finding the open man.
A little bit of a look off on that pass
as well. Yeah, she did a little something.
Goes again on a minute left, first quarter. Georgia by 11. Georgia in transition. Coombs overshot it, but an offensive rebound. Putback won't go for Bates.
And this is where, if you're Auburn, you have to try to get as many easy points in transition if you could. I know that you don't want to take rush shots, but with a team like Georgia, it's hard to get points in the paint when they're set on defense already.
Strong rebound there by
Beautiful.
Bates. And the outlet, Barker with the bucket.
And this is a clinic. Like, if you're Georgia, I'm sure that they've ran that drill in practice. It looks like a drill I've ran in practice. Execute it perfectly. And right here, if you're Auburn, you have to stay in the game. You have to keep your mind in the game. Rice, she looked defeated. The ball wasn't even out of bounds yet, and she kind of gave up on the play. You have to stay with it. You can't let the pressure deter you.
Shot clock off, 20 seconds until the half. Barker gets it over to Chapman. Into the front court with 15 until the end of the first quarter. Chapman looking inside.
And that's a good stop right there. That's good D by Auburn. Just keep it up.
Down to
Talk
five.
To each other.
Barker open at the buzzer. Knocks out the three.
Oh my goodness. That's how you feel, Barker.
Elbow bumps from Joni Taylor as her team comes off the floor. Georgia with a 16-point lead at the end of one quarter. Barker gets hot, got the layup in transition, then with the buzzer sounding, knocks out the three. Georgia in control early.
Grubhub perks give you deals on all the food that makes your boogie. Get the food you love with perks from Grub, what you love.
We are coming to you from Auburn, Alabama. Eastern part of the state over on the Georgia border, but this roster is built for players all over the globe. You've seen Ayesha Coulibaly today from Mali, played on the national team. Romy Levy, the first ever Auburn player from Israel. It's a lot of frequent flyer miles.
It is. And, you know, Israel is one of the places where a lot of WNBA players go play in the offseason. There's good basketball there. So, Levy, I'm sure she's seen some good competition young, and she's actually fitting in well here at Auburn.
You see that Coulibaly was MVP for that U16 team out of Mali. Played exceptionally well there.
And she's played well tonight. You know, there's not been a lot of bright spots for Auburn, but she has been one of those coming off the bench. She was an instant spark.
So how about this for Levy? Had to complete some required national service before being able to enroll at Auburn. She was a bronze medalist at the 18 Euro Championships with that U18 team from Israel.
Yeah, you know, I had a lot of teammates. I played in Israel before, and I had a lot of teammates that had to do the same thing. Do your 2 years of national service, and then you're free to do whatever else you like.
Barker from the wing, the whistle and a foul before. So a turnover there by Georgia. Richard Cross, Renee Montgomery with you from the Plains on this Sunday afternoon. So your international stops were Israel and where else?
Oh, all over. I played in Russia, Israel, Hungary, Australia, Lithuania, France. I could go on for a while. You're making me feel old.
You had to have the thick passport. You couldn't get the normal size. You had to get the one with extra pages.
I had pages added to my passport, and then it expired after 10 years, and I got a new one and a fresh start.
It's almost sad when all the stamps have to go away and you have to start all over.
Yeah, I save it. I definitely save it. And talking about starts, the start of this third quarter, Auburn getting a stop to start is exactly what you want to see if you're the Auburn coaching staff.
Strong drive there, but didn't have the finish. Auburn will keep it on the offensive end. 20 on the shot clock now.
You know, this is what is expected when you're used to having a player that dominates just the offense and dominates your defense, and then you're missing that player. It's tough to adjust. They've been missing Unique Thompson for two. This is the second game now. It's not as easy as just saying, okay, you fill in her spot. It's a whole different field. The rotations are different. Everything's different.
Stady with the block. That's her second of the game. And now Georgia. Well, they have absolutely run every time they've had a chance today. Barker feeds it into Stady. Turnaround from 8 feet. That's easy.
And that's easy. And with Stady, there were three defenders around her. She just kept the ball high, never brought it down, finished the shot.
Stady with 6 points already on her way to another double-digit performance. She scored in double figures 17 of the last 18 games going back to last season for Georgia.
Yeah, and I like that shot there by Aisha. She has to be aggressive, take it to the basket just as she did. Yeah, so here you see, here's the block shot. That length, again, barely leaving the ground, just keeping her arms out at all times. Now her team finds her. Again, there's people around her. That's a good contest by Aisha Koulibaly. There's not much you can do when she just keeps the ball high above her head. Great backdoor cut.
All loose, jerseys all over the place, and there was a kick ball in there.
And Dee Cantor let us know it. She had her leg kicking out there. She let us know it. Good hustle by both teams.
Eight and a half to go, second quarter. Georgia with an 18-point lead. They closed the first quarter with a flurry. Get it inside to Stady. She scores again. 8 points now for Jenna Stady on 4 of 6 shooting.
And if you're Auburn, you have to make sure that you're not behind Jenna Stady. I know you don't want to full frontal her, but you have to. That's too easy. If she gets the ball that deep, that's a bucket every time.
Three on the way, off the mark. Contested there for Koulibaly.
Yeah, and Koulibaly, she turned to her bench and said, that's my bad, I know. But again, I want her to stay aggressive all game. There's not many places where you can get scoring from. She has to stay aggressive. And here you can hear them talking now. That's what you have to do if you're the Auburn defense. Oh my goodness.
Not much of a window there, but a great find. And now Stady is in double figures for the 18th time in the last 19 games, you know, as Georgia leads it by 22.
That's a dime by Chapman. I know that we're talking a lot about Jenna, but that's a dime right there. There wasn't much space. She waited to the moment and found it.
So you see Jenna Stady on the year, 17 and a half points, 52% shooting. 6 double-doubles. We'll see if she's able to get a 7th in this ball game. And Jenna Stady doing it on both ends.
Definitely, and just look at her positioning. This is what I mean. The defenders are constantly behind Jenna. You can't be behind a player of her size. What can you do when she catches it right there? You have to find a way to get in front of her. Again, the way that she uses her length is a thing of beauty. That one, there's nothing you can do about that. She just did a turnaround fadeaway. There's not much you can do with someone her size doing a fadeaway.
All right, so let's go back to the defensive end for a second. So the first block was down on the block.
Yep.
The second time she got a block, it's 18 feet from the basket.
And they look the exact same, identical in a sense of she always has her hands up. She knows her length, she knows her size, and she knows how to use it. As a coach, you want to see her have her hands up all the time. She's going to always get deflections, and she uses it to her advantage and then finishes on the other end.
Renee, we know everybody was disappointed that we didn't get an NCAA tournament a year ago. Georgia may have been as disappointed as anybody because they were playing so well at the end of the season when it got shut down after the SEC tournament.
Yeah, and you know, as a player, as a coach, you can only hope to be ready and playing well when tournament time comes. It doesn't always work that way. You might be playing your best ball in the beginning of the season, the middle of the season. For Georgia, they really were playing their best ball leading up to the tournament, so I know that had to be a heartbreaker to have the tournament canceled.
Got some men's matchups coming your way on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Tuesday night, Kentucky back home at Rupp hosting Vanderbilt. Cats got a big double overtime win over Mississippi State in Starkville last night, so they'll try and make it two in a row. And then it is number 12 Missouri coming off a big win against Arkansas yesterday on the road in Starkville against Mississippi State. DJ Stewart, Iverson Molinar, great backcourt for the Bulldogs. Both of those games, SEC Network and the ESPN app.
Yeah, and you know, even just speaking about the tournament getting canceled, as we watch this game, we're watching it from the top of the arena. The teams are in their socially distanced huddles. It's a new normal, but I know that the players have to be just excited to be on the court. I feel like the players, as a player myself, the players probably want to do whatever they can to be able to play their season, because with college, you have a limited amount of time that you can be here.
Yeah, and you know, Renee, we look at the SEC in particular. You just made it through a football season, yep. And there were people that said, no, you can't do it. Well, they did it, and it wasn't easy. It had, you know, some ups and downs, a little bit of a roller coaster along the way. It feels like basketball is kind of taking the same approach. Now, we're going to do the best we can. We know there will be some fits and starts, but so far, mostly so good.
Yeah, definitely, and as I talked about, as a player, when you know you have a limited amount of time, you want to try to do whatever you can to get out on the court. That's
turnover.
Great hands.
Ball knocked away. So a turnover by Georgia. Ooh, Levy nearly gave it back.
Yeah, and that was Levy who got her hands on that pass. That's what you have to do. You can't let Georgia sling the ball around the court and pick apart your zone. Ooh. Again, that length. That length of Jenna is giving Auburn fits. I know it's deceiving. You can just tell that the players feel like they have an open look. She does the crossover step back. She feels like she's open, but that length of Jenna, she just barely gets her fingertips on the ball.
Three blocks in the game for Jenna Stady.
And she's averaging almost three a game, so she's right at her average right now.
Long jumper is an air ball, kept alive, but now Auburn, chance for transition. Little two-on-two break, all the way inside. Count the basket. Kyra Lowry aggressive on the drive.
And if you're Kyra Lowry, do more of that. Auburn needs some points in a hurry. It's hard to score against a set Georgia defense. Get it and go. And as you can see there, she finished with contact. More of it, please.
Lowry, one of the newcomers on this Auburn team, played at Dyersburg State Community College in West Tennessee. That is a good junior college program, has been for a long time. 10 players for Auburn made their debut when the season began, either freshmen or transfers in.
10 players. Think about that. That's nearly a whole team. That's and again, as we talk about it, 10 players making their debut and then one of your mainstays not being able to be there, that's tough. Another turnover, get it and go.
Fifth turnover of the game for Georgia. Auburn, though, only 1 point off of those five turnovers so far. Georgia's been able to capitalize with 11 off of Auburn's 9 turnovers.
And that's what I mean by Auburn. When you do get those turnovers and those opportunities like a Lowry did, you have to take advantage of it, just like she did there.
How about that power dribble from Jayla Jordan down the right side of the lane?
And that's what I'm talking about. You can't be passive and let the Georgia pressure keep you at the three-point line. As Jordan just did on that last drive, take it at them. There's that high post open. Then they look for the high-low.
This time it was Stady in the high post. She nearly comes away with an offensive rebound. That's touched last by Georgia, and so it's Auburn basketball.
And that's what you have to do if you're Auburn. That was Levy in there battling it out, but you have to. It's going to be by committee because Georgia is so much bigger than the Auburn team.
Auburn's had a little success with some drives to the basket. Levy can't get that one to go.
Yeah, and there you can see Levy was more so looking for a foul. You have to go to the basket with your mindset that if they call a foul, great. If not, finish anyway.
Three from the right wing, knocks it out. Maya Caldwell with the triple.
And that's a big shot for Georgia because it felt like the offense was a little bit out of sync, had a turnover to start the quarter, and then a couple more within the corner. So that's a big shot for Georgia there.
There is a turnover. A little bit of contact in the lane. Jayla Jordan may have been looking to draw the foul. Couldn't hold that pivot foot.
Yeah, and if you're Jayla Jordan, I love the aggressiveness. You drew two other defenders. That's when you pitch it to your teammates. Let them knock it in.
4.5 minutes until halftime. Georgia leading it by 21. There's the lob. A little too tall. A turnover by Georgia. As Caldwell, she saw that throw it high signal from Jenna Stady, but maybe not that high.
And Stady almost came down with it. Honestly, the pass, I thought it was going to go way out of bounds, but that's the length again of Jenna Stady. She almost came down with it.
Five new red jerseys
hockey
for
subs.
Georgia.
And that's the depth that Georgia has, though. You have five new players coming in, and I don't think Coach Taylor's concerned at all about a dip.
So Georgia with the full line change.
Good drive and kick. That's exactly what you have to do. Good finish by Jordan.
So Jayla Jordan.
And here, so when you draw other defenders, that's what you do, drop it off. And just a play before that, I was talking about Jayla Jordan. That's what she should have done. Once you draw an extra defender, your job is done. Now you look for the open man.
A little bit of a spark for Auburn from Lowry off the bench. Bucket got the assist there.
Yeah, Lowry's playing great because she's being aggressive and she's taking what the defense gives.
Nicholson left it short.
Good defense. This is what I mean by get in and go.
Jordan again, little spin move in the lane in the bucket.
Okay, is that how you feel? Okay, Jayla, that's exactly what you need to do, though. Score while the defense is still getting set. That's secondary offense. It's not necessarily transition, but secondary is just as good.
6 points from Jayla Jordan, originally from your home state, from West Virginia.
Mountain Mama. And right here, the Bulldogs, they have a Jenna Stady on the bench. If you're Auburn, this is the time that you have to pick and choose a time to run. So if you're going to try to make a push, this is when you do it.
Mallory Bates at the free throw line. It's not been great from there this year, 4-9 so far this season. Jayla Jordan will get a break. Goes to the bench with 6 points in this first half.
She played great. Like, that's, she should take a quick break, and you should try to get her back in there as soon as you can.
First free throw for Bates is good.
The reason that Auburn's had some late success here in the second is because of the aggressiveness of a Lowry, of a Jordan. A couple times, Jordan got herself in trouble with being too aggressive, but she'll take that. You just have to, it's a teaching moment. Just find the open man, but keep being aggressive.
Mallory Bates looked good on those two free throws. Auburn trying to claw its way back into this game, trailing by 19. Auburn quickly the other way, didn't get the roll. Bates pulls down the board.
That hit everything but the bottom.
Oh, Parker with the spin move. Couldn't finish.
That would have been pretty if that one had went down. And if you're Auburn right now, you almost have to not look at the score and play your game. Play an aggressive game.
And a travel there.
That's tough.
Lowry kind of drugged the foot.
She did. And again, I keep saying it because Auburn has to be aggressive. You just have to be under control with your aggressiveness. I love picking up the pressure. Auburn is still in that zone. The high post is the area that you have to try to keep the ball out of more.
Barker in the corner. And a 3-second violation on Georgia.
Yep, that's that 3-second violation. That was actually Bates that got that 3-second call, running the high post, trying to work the high post because that's exactly where she should be, but you have to get in and out.
As a player, when you hear the whistle and you see the official give the 3-second, you go, come on, you got to be kidding me. You could call that anytime. Why do you just randomly pick it now?
Listen, that sounds like post-player problems to me because I'm usually not in there long enough to get a 3-second call. But, you know, in the WNBA, we have a 3-second defensive call. Great offense right there. Great defense turning into offense by the Bulldogs.
Well, it was set up by Michaela Coombs, who was able to run it down and then have the presence of mind to find the trailing player, the bucket for Georgia, for Nicholson.
Nicholson, yeah. And good job by Nicholson, not assuming that Coombs is going to just get an easy layup. Kept continuing to run the floor and got the basket.
Georgia on the run out once again.
Great defense by Levy there.
What a nice job to get back. And a turnover by Auburn to carry. There's Lowry kind of had it hang on her leg.
She did, and Lowry, that's a couple turnovers in a short span. She's going to take a breather right now, but you have to find a way to keep the aggressiveness, but also have it be under control so that you don't get the turnover. And here's a look at this last run out here. Look at that, shooting the passing lanes. Again, everyone could have assumed that it was going to be a layup, but Nicholson didn't continue to run and got a gift for it, 2 points.
Did you see that little quick peek back right before she got to the ball, knew what was coming to help?
Yeah, and that's if you're Nicholson, that's your reward. You don't assume, it's like when we see a shot go up. You don't assume a shot is going in the same way Nicholson didn't assume that Coombs was going to make the layup.
Caitlin Hose has come in for the first time. It's her in the corner with the ball. Passes it up front to Barker.
And Auburn's doing a much better job now guarding the high post and guarding the weak side block, but not much you can do about that.
How about the floater from Coombs with 1 second on the shot clock? Georgia has pushed it out to a 41-18 lead with a minute left in this second quarter.
Yeah, and the thing I loved about what Coombs did is she was under control. You could tell she knew the shot clock the whole way that she was driving. Finish it with, like you said, 1 second to go on the shot clock. That's a heartbreaker if you're the defense.
Scott Grayson knocked that one away, and so Georgia inbounds in front of the Auburn bench. Maybe you should say like the Auburn area. I mean, it's spread out over like 1,000 square feet.
You got all the space you need.
Hose in the corner, feeds it into the low post, Bates.
You know, that was a great job by Jayla Jordan, keeping your hands straight up, not fouling, making, just living if the offense scores above you. And then she's going to come down and take a three. Okay, Jayla.
Do it on both ends. Get it done defensively, then knock out the shot on the opposite end of the floor. Shot clock is off. Mallory Bates kind of gathered herself, figured out where she was, and knocked out the little jumper.
And with size like Bates have, she did the right thing. She kept the ball up. Finished it over a smaller defender in Levy. Beautiful.
So a bucket for Elena Rice gets Auburn within 20 as we go to the half. Impressive first half by the Georgia Lady Bulldogs.
It was a very impressive half by the Bulldogs, but if you're Rice, you love to get something going really quick going into the half to give some type of momentum, as you see here. Jordan making the three, but a lot of Georgia going on.
Halftime on the Plains. Georgia up 20. Here's Alyssa Lang and Steffi Sorensen.
Year win, strength of character took center stage. And that was just the beginning. Same purpose, same goal, same bond, new year, same result. United, we ball.
Just about time for the start of the second half in Auburn, Alabama, where the Georgia Lady Bulldogs lead it by 20 at the half over the Auburn Tigers. Richard Cross and Renee Montgomery with you back at the half. And Renee, a pretty impressive first half from the Georgia Lady Dogs.
Very impressive. On both ends of the floor, it wasn't just an offensive prowess. It was the defense. They were getting after it. They were blocking shots. Just an all-around good half from Georgia.
And when you look at Georgia, we talked about this from the top of the show. You start with Jenny Stathy, and she did not disappoint in the first half.
Yeah, Jenny Stathy is one of those players that she does a lot, and it doesn't seem like she's trying hard. She doesn't get off the floor much. She's finishing around the basket. She's blocking shots, and then they're also making shots on the three-point end. When you're in a zone, as Auburn is, there's going to be a lot of open shots. Georgia's taking advantage of it and knocking it in.
First half stats, you see Georgia shoots 58% from the field, 4 of 6 from behind the arc. And how about the assist? 13 assists for Georgia on 18 made baskets. That's sharing the basketball nicely.
Yeah, and that's, you know what, and we saw it live. You could just feel how the ball was hopping around. I'm sorry, I called her Jenny. Jenna was the focal point. She was there at that low block. They were hitting the high post and dumping it down. That's exactly what you have to do with against the zone. Move the ball. It moves faster than the defender.
Leading scorers in the first half. We talked about Jenna Stathy, 10 points, a rebound, 3 blocks. Jayla Jordan kind of got it going late in the first half. Hit 4 of her 10 shots, has a block herself as well.
Definitely. And if you're Jayla Jordan, you have to stay aggressive in this second half. You got a couple turnovers, but you can't let that deter you. 4 for 10 isn't bad. 9 points. The Auburn is looking for scoring. It's going to have to come in the form of a Jordan, a Levy. They have to step up.
So basketball happening right now, but Fridays are for gymnastics. Gymnastics takes over the SEC Network every Friday night. A little Friday Night Heights this week. Gymnastics doubleheader starts in Athens with number 10 Georgia Gym Dogs hosting number 16 Missouri at Stegman Coliseum. That's at 7 Eastern, and then at 8:30 Eastern, number 15 Arkansas down at Baton Rouge to take on number 3 LSU at the Maravich Assembly Center. Both of those on the SEC Network and streaming on the ESPN app. So second half action coming up for Georgia and Auburn. From Auburn Arena, Georgia jumped out to an 8-0 start. Lost to Mississippi State in their SEC opener on Thursday night, 69-62. Going back to the end of last season, Georgia's won 13 of 17, and they've really played well. The only 4 losses, all of them coming to teams ranked in the top 20. A loss to South Carolina, the number 1 team in the country last year, to Mississippi State, to Kentucky, and to Texas A&M. So Georgia's kind of in that interesting place, Renee, where they're winning. They're winning all the games that they're supposed to win.
Right.
And then you try to take that next step.
Yeah, and this is how you take that next step. You have a 20-point lead coming out of half. You can't play to the level of your competition. You can't look at the score and think, okay, I'm just going to chill and coast for the rest of the game. You have to. This is where you learn, and you put teams away, and you prepare yourself for those ranked opponents.
Auburn ball to start the second half. What do you think the message was from Terry Williams Fenoy to her team at halftime?
You know, the message has to be forget the score. You know, get back, do what we do best, pay attention to detail. And again, on defense, there have to get some more bodies around Jenna because she's just a powerhouse down there.
Foul was on Maya Caldwell, her first of the game. Neither team with foul issues today. Levy trying to feed it inside. It's knocked away down low by Jordan Isaacs.
And Georgia's in a zone as well. Auburn tried to find that backside, weak side block. Georgia was aware of it because that's their play. Georgia's always hitting that weak side block, so they shouldn't get beat on it.
Georgia played 11 players in the first half, and 10 of those 11 players played 9 minutes. Nobody played more than 11 minutes in the first half. That's balance.
That's what you call balance, and that's exciting as a player too. If everyone knows they're going to get in the game, and not just get in the game for a quick 1 minute breather for your starters, but to play 9 minutes and get a real run at it, that gives players confidence. That makes them work harder in practice because they know they're going to get in the game. So that does a lot for a team.
No scoring so far in this third quarter. We are a minute in, and now Georgia in transition. They were maybe at their best in the first half. A little Euro step and a finish.
Excuse me, Maya, with the Euro. That was beautiful on the fast break. I didn't see it coming. Neither did the Auburn team. Euro step and one.
Maya Caldwell trying to finish off the three-point play. Took a page out of Renee Montgomery's transition book there, trying to score at the rim.
I would have probably pulled up for the three, knowing me, but I like what Maya did better.
Caldwell said, I'll try a three as well. She was off the mark with that one.
And Georgia's crashing the glass every single time.
Entering the game, the Auburn Tigers, number three, Annie Hughes.
Annie Hughes comes in. 20 seconds on the shot clock as Georgia inbounds underneath.
Oh, you had a player open in the corner. And Auburn again is in that zone defense. I like now that you see there's a player near Jenna at all times. Make them pass the ball around the perimeter. I know they've made a couple perfect defense. Great drop down by Levy. I know that Georgia's made some three-pointers, but you still have to pack the paint. Make them shoot from out there.
Almost perfect on that possession defensively from Auburn. They just couldn't get the ball out of the paint and into transition. And with the jump ball, Georgia keeps it.
And then
Georgia turns it over.
And it's only fitting that Levy gets it because she's the one that broke up the play, the possession beforehand. They just didn't secure it, but that's how you have to do. Make them beat you from the outside. No more points in the paint.
Levy, three from the wing. Got a whistle.
Foul after the shot.
That's on the closeout.
Maya Caldwell, that's her second and the team's second.
Yeah, she's saying basically she boxed her out before Levy could come down. And so the foul isn't on the three, it's after the shot.
So Levy came down. Maya Caldwell called for the push after that. And so Auburn gets another try.
And again, Auburn has to go downhill. Be aggressive, go downhill.
This foul is going to go against Jenna Stady.
Foul called on Georgia number 14.
But Jaylen Jordan is really working hard to get positioned down on the offensive end.
She is, and that's why. And I'm glad that they fed her the ball because that's how you have to make a defender work. So Jaylen Jordan posting up on the block, make Jenna Stacy work. Now, I don't know if that's what you want. I don't know if that's necessarily the matchup you want, but you have to go at good players. Try to get them in foul trouble. Try to make them work on both ends of the court.
Levy couldn't get the roll in the lane, coming off an 8-point, 11-rebound performance in the loss to LSU.
11 rebounds was her season high, or career high, I think, in rebounds with 11.
Good ball movement for Georgia. The three goes for Q Morrison.
Great shot by Q Morrison. Again, I said this in the first half, but they're going to give her that shot. It's just on her to take it and knock it in.
So 7 points in the game for Morrison.
And Georgia has has such balanced scoring. They have a player with 7, 5, 10. They're scoring in different areas, which makes it so hard to defend if you're in Auburn. And on this last one, again, it's that ball movement. We talked about at half, they had 13 assists on 18 baskets. We'll add another one to the list because that's an extra pass made for a bucket.
So Stady now has 3 fouls in the game.
And that's what you have to do. If you're Auburn, you can't be afraid to drive in the paint because you have such a shot blocker in Jenna. And she's as good as advertised, as you see. She already has, I think, 3 or 4 blocks in this game. But you do have to still go at her and find a balance of going at her while she's moving, not when she's just set.
They see some extended minutes here for Mallory Bates, the redshirt junior from Roanoke, Virginia, who backs Stady up.
Yeah, you are going to, because Stady has 3 fouls now, 7 minutes to go in the third. Not that Georgia's probably concerned, but this is an opportunity for a player like Bates to get some good game time minutes.
Free throws there for Kia Patton.
Auburn with the three-quarter court pressure. And if people are asking why are they doing that, that's just to throw off the offense, to make them rush a little bit. Georgia rushed, and they rushed to a basket by Bates.
Off the feed, Bates crashing to the lane, was able to finish it off. Georgia doubling up Auburn on this Sunday afternoon. Both of these teams looking for their first SEC win. Morrison. Gave it away, got it back, and now Georgia will, wow. How about that for Q Morrison?
Listen, that's how you feel, Q. I'm telling you, there's a flow to the game. When you know you're taking the right shot, when your teammates are finding you, shots go in, and you can see that right there for Morrison. It's also easy to make shots when, you know, you're up 25 points, so the rim gets a lot bigger when you're up a lot. Did that just hit the ref?
It did. It absolutely did.
So going. The ref is like, well, excuse me. Look at this shuffle pass. She dribbles out. She loses the ball a little bit, but when you're hot, you're hot. She just made a three. She steps back for a little 17-footer. Again, when things are going right, they're going right. the ref is still tickled. They was trying to get the ref a bucket. And if you're Georgia, I love the defensive intensity. Q got her hands on a ball right there. Don't just look at the score and just coast, as I talked about. They're still playing aggressive, and they're working on them. Easy basket right there in transition.
Gabby Connolly on the receiving end. She's able to finish at the rim. Georgia closing in on a 30-point lead.
And this is tough. If you're Auburn, you still have to stay with it. I know it's hard when you look at the scoreboard and they've doubled you up. You still have to do what you practice and play your game. Because right now, they're letting it turn into an avalanche. They're letting one turnover turn into 2 turnovers, 1 fast break turn into another one. You have to settle in at a certain point.
Offensive rebound and a put back inside for Jordan Isaacs. Just kind of tipped it up into the air until she could corral it.
Yeah, she was playing volleyball with herself.
Auburn will take a timeout. We'll take it as well. 4:53 left in the third quarter. Georgia up 31.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on all the food that makes your boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grubhub. What you love. Grubhub Perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make your boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grubhub. Grub, what you love.
Ohio State. The national championship game, Monday, January 11th on ESPN.
So we are getting close, but 8 days away from the national title game with Alabama and Ohio State. Alabama impressive against Notre Dame. Ohio State dominant against Clemson. Who's win? You got a winner?
Yeah, I got to go with Ohio State. My family would kill me if I didn't. I mean, my family, my dad's from Ohio. My aunties and them still live there. We literally call them the Buckeyes when they come to town. So I got to roll with the family and say Ohio State. Not that I necessarily think they're going to win, but I'm a, you know, okay. I have Buckeye ties.
That's fair.
I have Buckeye ties.
You're going to have to be on an island of one over there by yourself.
Shout out to my Buckeye family in Ohio, my aunties, my ditty down there. I mean, listen, I was born into it.
Kind of a contrast. You look at Auburn with a lot of new faces. Georgia has got seniors all over the place. Stady averaging 15 a game. Connolly averaging 10 a game, Q Morrison at 10 a game, Caldwell at 9 a game. That's a way to win a bunch of basketball games when you've got older players that are productive.
Absolutely, and you have seniors. That means something in college basketball. That means this is your last year, this is your last chance, this is your last round with your friends, who your teammates become your friends over time. So that leadership and that drive, it makes all the world of a difference. You can see it here tonight in a team where 10 newcomers are on one team, and then you got the starters holding it, I mean, the seniors holding it down for Georgia.
Y'all run the play!
Auburn comes up empty now, Georgia.
And if I'm Auburn, you have to just pick games to play within the game. Okay, we have 4.5 minutes left. What are we gonna do in those 4.5 minutes? It's not what the score is, it's what we do in that time frame. You have to break the game down to start setting goals for yourself.
Sarah Ashley Barker, air ball from the corner, but a loose ball grabbed. Is she going to ask for an assist on that?
Yeah, you might want to give it to her. Auburn has to make them one and done, though. They've done a good job throughout the game of making Georgia miss on the first shot, but Georgia's cleaned up a lot of their second chance points.
Coombs now with 6 in the game, a 10-0 run for Georgia, trying to increase that.
And you can tell Georgia has their pedal to the metal. Like, they are not looking at the score. They're still playing aggressively. They're still getting down on defense. Again, getting back in transition defense, which sometimes when you're winning by a lot, a team could get lackadaisical and not do the little things. But it looks like Georgia's staying locked in.
Levy had an open look that time, couldn't get it to fall. Barker turned down the 3 from the corner early in the shot clock.
And that's a good turn down by Barker, knowing that she can get that shot late in the shot clock if she wants to. They want to set up and run some offense.
A couple of programs here in the state of Alabama that might look at Sarah Ashley Barker and feel like she's one that got away. The Gatorade Player of the Year in the state of Alabama chose Georgia, said it felt like home. Really clicked with Joni Taylor, the head coach at Georgia.
Yeah, they definitely probably felt like she got away because she's a good player. As we saw, she made that 3 at the half, and she did have a razzle-dazzle play, didn't finish it, but you can tell she's gotten talent. She's got talent.
Georgia leading it by 35, 2:44 left in the third quarter.
Hey, Joni.
Hulu has live sports. Hulu.
Damn, that was dope. But it's Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
I don't know, man.
We can make that work, right?
Hulu doesn't just have live sports. It's a lifestyle.
Grubhub perks give you deals on all the food that makes your boogie. Get the food you love with perks from Grub, what you love.
Beautiful Sunday afternoon in Auburn, Alabama. Georgia leading at 60-25 over Auburn. Tiger fans may not think it's as beautiful. 2:44 left, third quarter. A women's basketball doubleheader coming your way on Thursday, we hope. Number 10, Arkansas, headed to Knoxville. Hopeful that Tennessee will be able to get back on the court after they've had to shut things down because of COVID-19, slated to host Arkansas in Knoxville at 6:30 Eastern. Then in the nightcap, number 13, Kentucky, number 9, Texas A&M from Reed Arena in College Station. You look at this Auburn team, obviously the score is not where you want it to be, down 35. You can't help but wonder what it might have been like. Unique Thompson missing her second consecutive game. Medical reasons, she's not injured. She's not in the building today. Preseason All-SEC, first team All-SEC a year ago. Watch list for the National Player of the Year. 18 and a half and 15 and a half. Such a big part of this Auburn team.
Definitely. I mean, if you just insert her into the game, it's 43 to 60. Just inserting her into the game, 15 rebounds. But what I think they really miss the most is an anchor, someone that draws the defensive attention and that people can play off of her. She goes from being the focal point of the defense to now other people who are usually, I would say, supporting cast now having to be the main Jane, and that's difficult.
Turnover there by Georgia, trying a little wraparound pass along the baseline, and nobody home on the receiving end. We also would have been treated to a matchup between Thompson and Stady down low.
Yeah, I would have loved that. I was excited for it. I was actually sad when I found out that Unique Thompson wasn't playing because I wanted to see that matchup. Jenna Stady, though, she's came out and showed well tonight just on both ends of the floor.
Stady's been on the bench for a while after picking up her third foul earlier in this third quarter. A little sloppy here for Georgia, a couple of turnovers.
It is, and if you're Auburn, again, you play a little game within the game. You got a couple of turnovers in a row. You just have to convert them. That's been the problem. 25 points on offense. It's going to be hard to win games like that.
Jump ball tie-up. This time the arrow keeps it with Auburn.
Jump ball, alternate position goes to Auburn.
And one thing that I've noticed Auburn is doing, they've been doing it a lot throughout this whole game, but they're paying more attention to the paint. Now they're making Georgia shoot shots from the perimeter if they're not getting a steal in transition. That's what you have to do. And here you got to get back in transition. Great wall up. You have verticality. You're allowed to jump straight up and down in the air. Jordan did that, but Barker finished anyway.
A 14-0 run for the Georgia Bulldogs over the last 5 minutes.
Yeah, and on this last break, great job by Barker staying under control. You're going full speed in the fast break. She takes it into the defender, finishes over, and that's a tall defender in a Jaylor Jordan. She still finishes anyway. Great no call by the ref. There was nothing there. Just a great finish by Barker.
Barker 7 points today on 3 of 6 shooting.
Yeah, she's played well. And even there, her passing up, she's passed up multiple threes. Good defense right there by Aisha. But she's passed up, Barker's passed up multiple threes, wide open threes. Okay, coast to coast, Aisha.
Aisha Koulibaly snaps that 14-0 run. And the drought for Auburn, they had gone over 5 minutes without scoring a point.
Yeah, yep. That basket was badly needed, and why not add a couple more on? Great pull-up right there. You'll take that shot.
Kia Patton got her own miss and then a foul on Georgia.
Yeah, and I got to see this coast-to-coast again. Aisha, I like it. They're jumping in, stealing the pass, and look, she said, I got this, guards. Don't worry. I'll take it coast-to-coast, finish it off. Like I said before, she's been a great spark plug for the team. At times, she's found herself getting a little bit out of control, but I love her aggressiveness, and she has to continue it. That Auburn just doesn't have a lot of firepower when it comes to offense. She can, again, make her defense turn into straight offensive points.
Patton, a 70% free throw shooter. That was the fifth foul on Georgia in this quarter, so a couple of free throws here for Kia Patton.
Yeah, and I'd like to see Patton be a little bit more aggressive, too. Not out of control, just aggressive.
7 points in the game, 5 of them from the free throw line. A little crossover and a trip there.
Yeah, it's a trip. And it seems like at times that three-quarter press for Auburn is getting them spread out to where it's creating driving lanes for Georgia. And Georgia's taking advantage of it. Oh, that's one that could be a steal. Ball is in the air for a long time. And if you're Auburn, you want to keep that ball around the outside. Perfect. Again? Wait a minute.
She was thinking coast to coast.
She
and then
was.
Got into a little bit of trouble, and then Georgia gives it right back.
She was. She was like, I'm going to do it back to back. She wanted to get it again, but jumping in those passing lanes, more of it. That's what Auburn has to do, not just Aisha, but the rest of her teammates. These passes are not crisp. They are stealable passes.
Aisha Koulibaly with 6 points today on 3 of 7 shooting. A couple of rebounds, a couple of steals.
And Aisha Koulibaly, she has 6 points. It feels like it's more just from her activity that she's been on defense and offense. She's been involved in a lot of plays. Oh. 2 seconds, let it fly. Auburn ends with a stop.
Pretty dominant third quarter by the Georgia Bulldogs. They outscore Auburn 19-6 and lead it 62-29.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make you boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grub, what you love.
62-29, Georgia over Auburn. 10 minutes to play as we go to the fourth quarter at Auburn Arena. Sir Charles in bronze outside. Oh, Charles Barkley.
That.
A couple of men's matchups on the hardwood coming your way on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Tuesday night, Kentucky and Vandy at Rupp Arena. That is at 7 Eastern, then at 9 Eastern, 8 o'clock Central Time. Mississippi State hosts number 12, Missouri. A good Konzo Martin team this year coming off a road win against Arkansas.
Listen, I'm going to let you finish, but these kids are turned up in here. I said, oh, whoop, daddy. These kids are turned. I love it.
Are we going to tell everybody you're dancing in your seat also?
Listen, I've been dancing. I'm not going to. This music's been good in here.
You're liking it. They're having a good time on a Sunday afternoon, regardless of the scoreboard here in Auburn Arena. And certainly not the crowd that you would normally have, but a few folks in the building able to check out a little Auburn basketball. Stady, 10 points, 4 blocks. Q Morrison, a couple of threes. She's got 9. Jayla Jordan has not scored in the second half. 9 points for the day. You see Stady there still on the bench. And then Koulibaly with 6 points for the Auburn Tigers. Auburn, of course, without Unique Thompson for the second consecutive game.
Yeah, and Stady might just stay on the bench. Again, 62-29, there's not much need to put her back out on the court. And this is an opportunity for players that don't get a ton of minutes, even though a lot of players on Georgia get a ton of minutes, it's an opportunity for them to get more minutes. It's good hands by Auburn.
That's the 18th turnover of the game for the Georgia Bulldogs, Lady Bulldogs. And there's one thing that Joni Taylor may not like about today. It's probably too many giveaways.
Definitely. And when we talk about beating those ranked opponents, you're not going to get away with giving the ball away that many times. So that's going to be a focal point. It's probably a focal point right now moving forward, even in this fourth quarter. Take care of the ball.
The lead for Georgia, 31 with 9 minutes to play. Lady Dawgs trying to pick up their first SEC win on another turnover, and now Auburn able to convert it into points the other way.
Okay, Robinson.
Morgan Robinson-Wagoo, the sophomore from Norcross, Georgia.
And if you're Morgan, you come in, you definitely don't pay attention to the score. You're a player that's out there. You're trying to show your coach that you can earn minutes. That's just how it is. They're putting you out there to see what you can do against this good Georgia team. You show them by being in the right position, taking the right shot, making shots that she just did.
Caitlin Hose short on the jumper there.
Oh. Got to make sure your man is looking at you. That was a miscommunication there.
Told you 10 newcomers, only one senior.
Wow.
Four juniors, and then you look at the underclassmen. Six sophomores, four freshmen. Unique Thompson, the only senior on the roster. And
experience matters, you know, and you see it definitely in the pros where in free agency coaches talk about we have to go get some veterans. LeBron James left Cleveland to go to Miami to get that experience. It's really tough to win games and to prepare and understand how to win games without that leadership.
Shot clock deep in the shot clock, and then we get
tough.
A bailout whistle.
That's tough.
Auburn number 23, Honesty Scott Grayson.
I mean, that was probably 28, 29 seconds of great defense by Auburn, then a foul at the end, which, I mean, you got to just keep doing it. You can't, I always say it, but you get frustrated because that's 28 seconds, but a coach would say, we need 30.
Offensive rebound dug out by Georgia.
And you have to be impressed with the way Georgia came out tonight. It's a new year. You know what people say, new year, new me? Well, Georgia's looking good in this 2021 year.
Transition bucket there for Honesty Scott Grayson. So she picked up the foul late in the shot clock just a second ago. Makes up for it there with a bucket in transition.
Super fast. I mean, she got down the court quick. Auburn has to do that if they can turn their defense into offense. Get points while the Georgia defense isn't set yet. And I love her name, Honesty.
Into the lane. A little scoop won't go.
Get it and go. Get in and go. If you're Auburn, I would be out to the races every single time because that set Georgia defense is tough.
Again, Honesty Scott Grayson on the drive. She's got free throws coming up.
Yeah, and that's a good aggressive drive. And speaking of Honesty, look how quick she gets down the court. It's just her in the rim. She finishes it off, and then she follows it up right now with another drive to the basket, gets fouled, two free throws.
Quality minutes for Honesty Scott Grayson off the bench. She's originally from New Jersey, transfer from Georgia. Big-time player coming out of high school. 2018 McDonald's All-American. Redshirted last year after the transfer.
Yeah, Auburn has some players that you're excited to see how they develop in the future. She's one of those. They're athletic. They have experience, as you said, McDonald's All-American. Some were in the Mali Olympic team, like the Junior Olympics. But that's what you want. You want those young players. They're going to have to grow up in a hurry. You know, you don't have the luxury of figuring it out. You're out there on the court right now. You're going to have to figure it out here.
Six points for Scott Grayson in the game today.
And there goes Georgia again with that ball movement. It's a missed shot, another offensive rebound. The ball movement, woo, good find. The ball movement has just been spectacular today for Georgia.
Maury Davenport with her first point, sophomore from Troy, Alabama. Transfer from Rutgers, and she was ruled immediately eligible back in mid-December with the rules that we've got in place this year.
Yeah, and look at this last pass. First of all, offensive rebound. Great O board right there by Coombs, but the wherewithal, there's a lot of traffic. You're in the paint. I feel rushed sometimes when I'm in the paint and I'm a guard. Found her man at under the basket. Beautiful pass.
Feed inside, Zoesha Smith.
And Jayla Jordan has done a great job in the paint of just keeping her hands straight up and down and living with whatever happens after that. She's gotten a lot of deflections. I don't know if they're called, they're going to consider them blocks, but she's, that's a block. That is a
and
block.
Another one from Maury Davenport off the bench. Goodness. Got a bucket, couple of blocks on the defensive end.
That's
and now
a block.
Pose from the corner.
Davenport is all over the court. She's diving for loose balls, blocking shots. She's on the other end. She might get a cherry pick if they see her.
A long pass, little too much. Backboard saved them, and a bucket for Maya Caldwell. That's the kind of day it's been for Georgia.
That was a doozy. But I love it. I love the hustle of Davenport. Make the most of your minutes. Another one.
Three blocks in the last two possessions for Maury Davenport, and now Coombs. Free throw's coming.
And it looks like Davenport, she looks tired, and rightfully so. She's been on both ends of the court. What is your day? It's your day. My goodness. Off the backboard. That's a pass. Are we going to consider that a pass? I don't know, but it's a bucket.
You guards are always begging.
Hulu has live sports. Hulu.
Damn, that was dope. But it's Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
I don't know, man.
We can make that work, right?
Hulu doesn't just have live sports. It's a lifestyle.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on all the food that makes your boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grub, what you love.
4:48 left in Auburn, Georgia, on its way to its first SEC win. Maury Davenport earning some minutes late in this ball game. Started with the bucket and then doing work on the defensive end.
Listen, she got some late minutes and she made the most of them. Woo, not once, but twice. I'm talking about full hand palm on the ball. That one was a two-handed block. I love, too, that after she got the block, she gathered the ball, threw a pass ahead to start the fast break. I see you making the most of your time, Davenport.
66 points for Georgia today. Gymnastics takes over the SEC Network every Friday night, and this week our gymnastics doubleheader starts in Athens. Number 10, Georgia hosting number 16, Missouri at Stegman Coliseum at 7 Eastern. Then it's number 15, Arkansas, number 3, LSU from Baton Rouge. Both meets on the SEC Network and streaming on the ESPN app.
I'm
Richard Cross and Renee Montgomery with you. So I just made up your name on the
clock. No, it's okay, Richard. I'm going to tell you what. These kids, when we talk about energy, the Auburn fan base has not lost 1 ounce of energy since tip-off.
You think it's sugar high, or maybe go see what they're serving at the concession stand today?
It's probably a little bit of everything. Excited to probably be out the house, the kids, for a little while, but it's been fun to watch them in the stands. I'm telling you, I don't know who's on the ones and twos. They're killing it.
Michaela Coombs, first free throw, good. Got them both 8 points in the game for Coombs.
And that's probably the last time we'll see Coombs. And she had a great game. I mean, just throughout the whole game, she was making the right passes, reading the defense, and then doing her own thing on offense. So great job by Coombs tonight.
So Chloe Chapman came into the game. Chloe Chapman, a two-sport athlete. Plays on the Georgia soccer team.
Oh, nice. And one.
Kia Patton. There you get a look at Chloe Chapman. She is doing something that not many folks have done at Georgia. Led a year ago Georgia with 6 goals scored and then transitions over to basketball. This is her 4th game of the year. She missed the first 6 because of soccer. Took just a little bit of time in between the end of the SEC tournament and the start of basketball for her. Just to kind of rest her legs.
Man, I don't know how she did it. I played basketball full-time at UConn. You can forget if y'all wanted me to play soccer. I played soccer in high school. There's no way. So unbelievable mental toughness by her. Taking a little break. I need a lot more than that.
Get Patton on the pull-up. There's an offensive board. Won't go for Jayla Jordan. And now we do see Jenna Stady back into the game.
And I'm surprised to see Jenna Stady back in the game. But I bet Jenna probably wants some, you know, everybody wants to get in on the action when it's going good.
A little crossover there to foul. I think that's going against Chloe Chapman.
And Lowry's done a good job when she's been under control right there. She did a little Euro step to get to the free throw line. She can get to the basket. Now she just has to work on being under control. And then when multiple defenders come at her, finding the open man.
Jevin Nicholson back in. Just finishing up the Chloe Chapman. She is one of only six female student athletes at Georgia that have ever played two sports. Tina Price did it with basketball and tennis. Donna Noonan, basketball and golf. Beth Timmons, basketball and swimming back in 2000. Our very own Maria Taylor, who of course played basketball and was a volleyball player. You had Stephanie Paul and now Chloe Chapman.
Okay, I mean, that's an elite group because just the amount of time and energy, mental toughness it takes to play one sport in college, much less two, that's a different breed. They are a different breed, and Chapman is one of those. And here you can see Georgia, they're taking, they're taking their time, moving the ball around. Somebody's going to have to take a shot, though, and get to the hoop.
On the drive, a scoop, and a finish with one left on the shot clock. Georgia keeps making baskets.
Maya Caldwell, I mean, that was beautiful with the shot clock going down. I didn't know if she recognized it, but she got there in time, finished it, I believe, on the left.
Levy too strong with the three. Barker pulls down the rebound. Georgia in transition. They've made 30 baskets in the game. Season high came against Gardner-Webb when they had 39 makes. Stady missed it, got her own miss, missed another one. Third time she draws the foul.
Third time's a charm. She was playing volleyball down there with herself. I love the way Jenna uses her body. She doesn't let the defenders get between her and the basket. Here, she's positioning herself, trying to get it. She knows she misses it. The best person, if you shot it, you know where the miss is going. You can see she's probably a little frustrated with herself for missing the first couple, but great job by her for staying with it. She's a powerhouse down there. I love to see it. Especially in a time where a lot of basketball is moving against the traditional big. She's a traditional big that gets it done and at a high level.
Stady's got 11 points in the game now. You know, she had those three misses down there, but got a couple of offensive rebounds. Maybe looked at the rebounding numbers and knew she needed to
pat the stats.
Nobody needs to do that.
No one does that on purpose. You don't want to hear your coach's mouth about it.
On the drive, on the glass, Annie Hughes with the make.
That's a tough shot by Annie Hughes over the outstretched arm of a Jenna.
Around inside and the putback. Good one there for Javen Nicholson.
And she's done well. You know, she sprinkled in some points throughout the whole game, just being active. Offensive rebounds, putbacks, right place at the right time.
Ball loose on the floor. Georgia digs it out.
And Auburn has tried to hit that backdoor pass many, many times this game. Georgia scouted it well. You have to give Georgia credit for coming in and knowing what Auburn wants to do. They've stolen at least three or four of those backdoor passes.
Tipped around. Chapman able to save it around half court. Shot clock inside 10. Nicholson too strong.
And that was the same spot that Nicholson had just made the previous shot from. That one didn't go in, but Nicholson always seems to be in the right place at the right time. That's a shot for Barker right there.
Could knock it out from the corner. Hughes with the rebound.
And I love the way Barker has been very patient, picking and choosing her moments to shoot. That was the right shot there to shoot it, even though there was time left on the shot clock. She's passed up a lot of threes. There goes that back door again. Georgia's waiting on that pass, so I don't know if Auburn's going to be able to get it. I know that they probably practice it a lot, so it's almost innate to make that pass, but Georgia's on it.
You look ahead. Auburn hits the road next for a game against Ole Miss.
It doesn't get easier for Auburn.
Gillette, McPhee McEwen doing a good job trying to build that program at Ole Miss. And it certainly doesn't get easier for the Georgia Lady Bulldogs. To tell you how badly they needed this one after dropping the opener to Mississippi State, time to head to Columbia, South Carolina.
There she goes again. That's Nicholson cleaning up the glass. Just, that's all effort. There's nothing else to that play but effort, hustle. And she deserves those two free throws because she's been working hard down there in the paint.
Now, you're probably more qualified for this than anybody because of who you played for in college. But when you look at South Carolina and the job that Dawn Staley has done, you look at her initially and she's building a team. And she's turned it into a program. And it's remarkable what they've been able to do.
It is, and she's one of those coaches, like, you know, she's a cool coach that you feel like, we call them a player's coach, where you feel like they can relate to you, you can talk to them. She's been a player before, so she understands, she gets it. I love to see her do well. She's one of those coaches that you just, unless she's playing against UConn, you have to just wish her well. And, you know, I'm a Husky, I bleed blue, but unless she's playing against UConn, I love to see her do well.
Tony Taylor and Terry Williams-Fanoy. Now veterans in the league. Tony Taylor in her sixth season at Georgia. Williams-Fanoy, ninth year here at Auburn.
Yeah, both heading some great programs. Joni with that Georgia program, and she's another one. You know, I've had the opportunity to be around her sometime, and she's one of those people that find the optimism wherever she can. So when you're a coach and you have long seasons, you might go through stretches where the team isn't playing well, the season seems like it's grueling, you need that type of optimism. So I'm sure she provides that for her ball club.
Down to the end, a few whistles at the end as we've got
Auburn, number five,
20 and a half seconds remaining.
That's our second and the team fifth.
30-point lead for Georgia.
Tough. It's tough. It's tough if you're Auburn, and I know that you're at home, but I want people to understand there's really no such thing as a home court advantage right now in these times where there's only a sprinkle of fans allowed in. So it's tough to face a strong Georgia team who plays 11 players deep, and you're missing your main Jane, your star player in a unique Thompson, your leading scorer, rebounder. It's a tough matchup.
Stady with the rebound. Georgia should be able to dribble it out now. Barker into the front court. She's guarded by Auburn's Carson McFadden there at the very end. A 32-point win for Georgia as they move to 9-1 on the season. Back-to-back losses in SEC play to start things for Auburn. Certainly, they are going to be ready to get Unique Thompson back as quickly as possible.
Absolutely, and there's certain things you can't rush, but I'm sure the coaches wish they could, wish her the best, but you got to get your hats off to a Georgia team that came in and they handled business.
So Georgia, after the loss to Mississippi State, bounces back with a win on the road against Auburn, 76-44, the final. Pretty balanced scoring day for Georgia across this roster. We'll take a timeout, wrap things up from Auburn. When we come back, Georgia, a winner on the Plains.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on all the food that makes your boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grubhub. What you love. Grubhub Perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make your boogie.
Get the food you love with Perks from Grub, what you love.
And we welcome you one last time to the Plains in Auburn Arena, where Georgia picks up its first SEC win of the year, evening the mark at 1-1. Auburn falls to 0-2 in the league, 76-44. Lady Dogs over the Auburn Tigers. Richard Cross, Renee Montgomery with you. And really, this one, all Georgia from the beginning.
Oh, definitely. And Georgia was already new. Like, this is what you have to do. If you're going to be a good team, you have to win the games you're supposed to win. And then you have to win some of those ranked games. So Georgia did what they were supposed to do and beat an Auburn team that was out without their main scorer.
Jenna Stady led the way for Georgia. 13 points, 5 rebounds, 4 blocks. Keeva Patton with 12 points on 6 of 7 shooting today. Auburn struggled from the outside. You see, only 1 of 11 from behind the arc. Auburn up next will travel to Ole Miss. Georgia will stay on the road as they go to face South Carolina coming up. And it's a Georgia team that's playing with some confidence. Now 9-1 on the year and 1-1 in SEC play. That's going to do it for us from Auburn Arena on this Sunday afternoon. Thanks for being with us. Georgia impressive in red on the road. For Renee Montgomery, I'm Richard Cross. We appreciate you being with us. Coming up in, just a few minutes at the top of the hour, Mizzou and Auburn from Fayetteville. Our final in Auburn, 76-44, Georgia over the Auburn Tigers. Have a great rest of the weekend.
Welcome into this SEC House.